For the first time ever, Mr. and Mrs. Brian and Tamia win.
Well, Tamia and I went to high school together, Ben L. Smith High School. She was the new girl in class, so you know everybody thought she was beautiful and fine. So did I. I just didn't say nothing to her back then. She didn't catch my eye at that time. But some time went on. We both went to different colleges, and I don't know. I just saw on Facebook one day. I know that's super corny, but saw that on Facebook one day, and I was like, man, I'ma holler at Tamia. So. Ended up sliding up in the message box. I got her number and we just kept in contact, but more like friends at first though. Of course, as time went on, you know, I tried to take it a little bit further. She gave me the cold shoulder though. Yeah, nice little Heisman on you, boy. But it's all right though, because eventually she gave in. She stopped tracing my phone calls. She stopped following me around and she finally was like, yo, I love you, baby. And I was like, all right, let's make it happen. That's how we met though.
Her eyes make the stars look like they're not shining. Her hair falls perfectly without her trying. She's so beautiful.
We were in college. He called me and told me he liked me. And I was like, no, I got a boyfriend. Not really interested. So that following summer, we were going to be juniors in college. And I decided to finally let him take me on a date because he kept asking to go out. So I was like, okay, let's go on a date. And my first date was at US Sushi, and that was the first time I actually saw Brian other than being real silly and goofy. I saw him as being like a real, like a person, like not like a person, but I saw that he had more depth. He had more depth. He had more depth than just being the class clown that I knew him to be. And here we are. 8 years later. Stops and stares for a while, 'cause you're amazing, just the way you
are. Oh, her eyes make the stars look like they're not shining. Her hair falls perfectly without her trying. She's so beautiful.
I appreciate her though, honestly though, this is honest, because on the date, I was like, yeah, order whatever you want, you know, most guys would. And you know, she's like, yeah, I'm gonna try some sushi. And I'm sitting here like, okay, you know, she down for the sushi, that's what's up. Next thing you know, she ate that first bite and I could just tell like all in her face. I was like, oh, she does not like this at all. But she thugged it out for me, she kept eating. And I was like, you know what, if you wanna order something else, just go ahead and order, because I'd rather you be happy than waste some stuff. But that kind of showed me something though, just being that she's willing to try something new with somebody new, and that kind of like opened up the door to, you know, wanting to dig a little bit deeper. So first date definitely showed me a lot indirectly, but I definitely appreciate it looking back on it now for sure though, because it tells a lot about her now, just being able to sacrifice and, you know, wanting to do new things with me.
I really got to, like I said before, know him a little bit better, understand him a little bit better. And I think actually the first day is what actually really made me be interested in Brian. Pulling me further, further than I've been before. Making me stronger. Shaking me right to the core. Oh, I don't know what's in the stars. Never heard it from above. The world isn't ours, but I know what's in my heart. If you ain't mine, I'll be torn apart. I don't know who's gonna kiss you when I'm gone.
She came to my game.
You talking about something else. He said, when did we start dating?
No, you're talking
about... That was
about,
before then.
You're talking about South Carolina State. That's
okay,
what you're
so, okay,
about.
So what happened? Okay,
I'm talking about Florida A&M, and it was kind of like official, like, you know, give a hug and a kiss type thing. Like, all right, this is official. And we played on ESPN that night and lost. I'll never forget
okay,
that.
Okay, back to us.
Yeah, but she supported me. And from that point, I know for sure we were boyfriend and girlfriend.
We started dating September the 12th. So...
And if you look at your clocks and rewind back, we played Florida A&M.
Yourself a wife or you'll be lonely. Once I was 11 years old. Oh. I always had that dream, like my daddy before me. So I started writing songs, I started writing stories. Something about that glory always seemed to bore me. Cause only those I really love will ever really know me.
Okay, so after the game, I was riding back with his parents and we were obviously going home and we were texting. And he texts me, I L you. So I'm like, I'm reading this and I'm excited because I feel the same way, but I'm gonna make him work for this because I'm at like, I don't know what he's talking about. So I text him back and I was like, what are you saying? And he was like, you know what I'm saying. And I said, no, I don't. So I said, just say it. What are you saying? And then he goes, I love you. Honestly, when we first started dating, it was different. I had been in relationships in the past where I wasn't respected like I should have been. And so that's why they didn't work out, because we ended up breaking up. But when Brian came along, it was just different because he treated me different. He treated me more so, I would say, like my dad treats me. And that's really what I was looking for in a guy.
One thing I could definitely say I've learned in our relationship about myself is, even though I like to think I'm an effective communicator, that's something I still need to work on. Just being that is one of the most crucial parts of a relationship is communicating effectively. So that's something I've definitely learned about myself. And it's something I definitely think I grow on. But especially being with someone, you know, who's passionate about you and your relationship, it makes it a little bit easier because you have someone there to guide you and walk through that process with you. But that's one thing that also, on the flip side, helped me, you know, to learn about her as well. Just the support, sacrifice that it takes, you know, when you're dealing with somebody else. All of those things we've definitely learned. You can kind of get a feel when you first start the relationship, but now we've progressed a lot. You could definitely, that's one thing I've learned for sure, that, you know, the loyalty is there. The respect is there, just helping to push that person, having goals, visions, dreams, passions that you're trying to achieve together. I feel like that's something I've learned, not only about myself, but about to be as well.
We've literally been through all the phases of becoming an adult together, and we were able to maintain that because as you know, you grow and you grow in different ways, but we were able to grow in our own different unique ways that we needed to grow in, but we were able to grow together. And I agree with pretty much everything he says, but that's really what I focus on, like when I really reflect and think about the relationship, is the fact that we were able to come into our own as being just graduated from college. And because, you know, at that point in time, that's like a real pivotal point in your life, because it's like, I'm real grown now, what do I do next? And you go through different challenges and you face different things, but we were able to face different things in our own ways, but then still keep it together.
Hello, we are not available now. Please leave your name and phone number after the beep. We will return your call.
As usual, you aren't paying attention to your phone, but this time I'm not even mad. I'm actually glad you didn't answer, because I wanted to leave you a message right before I come down the aisle and you see how beautiful I look and you're overtaken and you cry hysterically. Just kidding. But I did want to let you know that you are the best thing that has ever happened to me. Ever since we began dating, this thing that we have, it's just been different. It's been organic. We haven't had to force it. It's just happened and it just feels right. Your love has been patient, kind, understanding, and unwavering. And I just want to thank you for that. Every little girl wants someone like her father. And I see you as being one of the greats, like my father. I love you now and forever. Love. To Mia. Oh wait, P.S. Me and you, just us two. But around the time he came back into my life, I was praying for somebody to come into my life who would treat me right, who would treat me like my father, because that was most important, and who would cherish me and who I could grow with. And then, you know, Brian comes, and initially I was reluctant to give him a try, but I'm so glad that I did, because now 8 years later, here we go.
No relationship is perfect, mm-hmm. and you know, it never will be, honestly, but when you both can get to the point where it's like, all right, even through those imperfections, you still willing to deal with that person, and you know, still want to live with that person and continue on, that's something that anybody can appreciate. But when you find it, you know, don't shy away from it, because you know, in today's world, it's like, you know, we get some conflict, and you know, first thing we want to do is turn around and run. But you know, even if it takes, you know,
especially with our generation,
a breakup here too. You know, sometimes those things happen, but when you get away from that person, and it's just like, oh man, you know, I wonder what they're doing. You know, I wonder what's going on. You know, that's when you can tell you genuinely have some feelings about somebody.
Mia Shanae Davis.
Oh, no, not the feeling,
right? I love you, girl. Ever since I first saw you, Ben L. Smith High School, I knew you had a little something special in you. You know? And even though we didn't, you know, initially have that first relationship that most people, you know, start off with just being real good friends, we kind of noticed each other at a distance. You came to me at a time of my life that was very, very important. I was maturing a lot as a man, I was growing, and I was definitely looking for someone to settle in. And all I did was looked on Facebook. Yes, y'all, Facebook. Looked on Facebook. You had on that black shirt with them red heels with the black. And I was like, yo, I told my pops, baby, I gotta holler. Ooh, gotta holler. But this day, I love you so much, baby. There's so many things that I could say, but words do not do justice to describe the love that I have for you. Ever since I first laid eyes on you at Minj, and I saw those wings, and you brought them out to me, I knew we was gonna be together. I love you with all my heart, Tamia. I love you with everything I have in me. I love you with all of my being. Every time I look at you, I smile. Even when we get upset at each other, I still smile, because I know I love you that much and I'm willing to do whatever for you. I'm willing to sacrifice my love for you, my life for you. I'm willing to do everything. I'm gonna go above and beyond. I promise to be your protection. I promise to be your biggest cheerleader. I promise to be your love and support, and I will always be there for you. And I promise that with all of my being from to this day until forevermore. And I thank you for walking into eternity with me.
I don't know, it was just different. And I don't really remember the time that I actually sat down and really was like, I think I love Brian. I just think it was just always there. It was just something different about him.
Brian, I take you to be my husband. I will love you unconditionally and without hesitation, for it is your heart that moves me, your spirit that inspires me. Your humor that delights me, and your hand I want to hold for all the days of our lives. I promise to be strong when you are weak. I promise to make our home a safe haven for you. I will let you watch your shows from time to time. But if my shows are on, I'ma watch my show because I'm older. I will be understanding, open, and honest. I promise to love, respect, and trust you and give you the best of myself. For I know that together we will build a life far better than even either of us could imagine.
Tamia,
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As I place it on your finger.
As I place it on your finger.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I ask you to wear this ring.
I ask you to wear this ring.
As a reminder of the vows we have spoken today.
As a reminder of the vows that we have spoken today.
On this, our wedding day.
On this, our wedding day.
Brian, I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As I place it on your finger.
As I place it on your finger.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I also ask you to wear this ring.
I also ask you to wear this ring.
As a reminder of the vows we have spoken today.
As a reminder of the vows we have spoken today.
This our wedding day.
This our wedding day.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing?
Hey, Brian, now that you married Big Dog, I definitely want to tell you, let's keep it together, keep growing, take care of this beautiful woman that you've been given the gift of, and make sure that your family is taken care of, all right? I know you got it in you. I've been with you your whole life, you know what I mean? So go ahead and do what you're supposed to do, and love her like you never loved her, take care of you like you never take care of anybody, and always keep the Most High first, for sure.
First of all, I want to say, finally, you is married now. No, but I just want to say, communicate your feelings to Brian. Work things out. Don't always be so hard on him. Relax a little bit. Take time to just cherish the little moments that you guys have together. And just try to be as open with him as you can. Keep God first. Continue to be the kingdom woman that you are. And allow him to be the kingdom man that he is, that he can grow into be, that he will grow into be. And same with you.
Proposal. It was like one of those things. I definitely wanted to talk to her parents first. So I actually did that on Christmas Day. And I spoke with her mom and her dad, and you know, they definitely approved, which I'm glad of, and I appreciate that. Just because I saw that they, you know, care enough for me to trust me with their daughter. But fast forward, for me, I'm the worst at planning stuff. I keep it real. That's not my forte, that's not my strong suit. So definitely something I need to work on. But you know, I definitely wanted to do something nostalgic, you know, to our relationship as far as the location. And of course, we have a friend, Autumn, who was like, yeah, you know, you should capture all these moments with, you know, photos. So she introduced me to Q, and it was just like, yeah, you know, Q. So, you know, I got these ideas. I want to do it here, maybe here. But the worst weather ever was on that day. So it was kind of like we were scrambling at the last minute. And then all of a sudden, I was like, you know, Natty Greens, because we actually had our first kiss at Natty Greens. So I was like, all right, that would be very, you know, nostalgic, and, you know, something significant to our relationship where we could do it at.
So I spent the night with him that night. So we woke up, and it was, what, the day before New Year's Eve? Yeah, the day before New Year's Eve. So our friends, Amanda and Ruben, had invited us to come to Charlotte and bring in the New Year with them. So we were looking for, we had to look for outfits that day, so I already knew that was gonna happen. So he's like, oh, let's go get, you know, our nails and stuff done. Okay, that's not out of the ordinary, fine. So we did that. And then, you know, we went to the mall to look for, piece together some outfits at the last minute. And like he said, he kept walking away and not being on his phone. And I was like, that's weird, cause he doesn't do that. So I was already looking at him like he was crazy.
I found love in you. And I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you.
So we get downtown, and he parks away from the actual store location, he says, initially. So I'm like, okay, I don't have time for this, because it's like drizzling, right? So we walk, and then he's like, no, let's go right here. And so I'm like, well, you know, in Natty Greens, at a certain time they gotta check your ID to go in there. So I'm like, why are you trying to go through the gate? Let's go in here. So he's like, no, let's go through here. And I was like, oh, okay, whatever. And so then there's a photographer, and he's like, oh, I forgot PJ said he's gonna have some a photographer here taking pictures. So I'm like, don't have time for this, not feeling it, past it, let's go.
No other love will do. Every moment that you smile chases all the pain away.
So I sit down with an attitude, and I'm just sitting there like this. And then Brian sits down in front of me, and he starts saying like, oh no, I love you so much, and did it. And I'm like, okay.
Little did she know.
All right. And that's not out the norm, because Brian says, you know, says little stuff like that all the time. So I'm looking at him like, okay, so I'm, sir, go ahead and take these little pictures so we can go ahead on. And then I hear something behind me, so I turn around and it was Reggie, Brian's brother. He's holding a box, and I'm like, okay. So, okay, so here we go. So then, of course, my mood changed.
I love you. I do. This is why I love you. Oh, this is why I love you. Because you love me.
Those magic words, and she said yes. She said yes.
I say about
it. It felt like it happened so fast, though. It's like, you know, you stress about planning and everything, and all of a sudden, it's just like, all right, she got a ring on. It's just like everybody looking at her ring, and they forget all about you. It's just like, you know, look at Brian over there. That's a nice ring, girl.
Respect you like a lover. Oh, wow.
Can bet that, never gotta sweat that. You can bet that, never gotta sweat that. You can bet that, never gotta sweat that. You can bet that, never gotta sweat that.
If you be the cash, I'll be the rubber band. You be the match, I'ma be your fuse. Boom, paint it, baby, you can be the muse. I'm the reporter, baby, you can be the news. Cause y'all the cigarette. And I'm a smoker, we raise a bet. Cause you're the joker, choked up. You are the joke, and I can be the backbone. You can be the
I guess, but telling my friends, they probably saw the difference in our relationship. And I had a core group of friends that I hung around. And we were all literally always together, especially on the weekends. Because most of them, two went to UNCG, one went to ANT, and then I went to Central. So we were always together on the weekend. But every weekend, they kind of noticed, you know, I would have to go off and I would have to spend time with Brian and all that good stuff, and the group thing that we always did every weekend kind of dwindled. I would always make, you know, different stuff with them, but I would always be like, all right, I gotta go see Brian now. So,
what can I do to deserve that? Baby, I'll be the pen. Say that I'm the one, cause you are 10. That's really not pretend. Even when the sky comes falling, even when the sun don't shine, I got faith in you.
Thank you.
friends that I have, they're very supportive of me and they know me personally. And they were just, you know, pushing me towards it because, you know, we are fortunate enough to have a lot of friends that are in relationships. Some married, some, you know, fresh in relationships, but just to have those type of people around you and communicate that made it a lot easier for me. So it wasn't really too much I was uncomfortable with in terms of speaking with other people about.
Just keep each other first, because now it's all about the two of you, mom and dad, and his mom and his dad and brother. They come second. God comes first. He comes first. And for him, I come first. After God. And then everybody else. So we just need to remember God, each other, everybody else.
Mr. and Mrs. Wynn, brace yourself. It's not going to be perfect, but as long as you got the Most High, you got each other.
You are bound. You can rest on sacred ground.
Think I'm